Hello, and welcome to the Collins Center for the Arts at the University of Maine. May I please have your attention for an important safety announcement? Please take note of the exits at the rear and on both the left and right sides of the theater. In the unlikely event of an emergency, remain seated and listen for the evacuation procedures. Please follow the instructions given by the ushers and public safety personnel. If this event is to resume, you will be readmitted for seating. Finally, as a courtesy to all in attendance, please disable any audible alarms on your cell phone. Thank you very much and enjoy your visit.
Thank you. Good morning.
Good morning.
I am honored to welcome our faculty and staff, our trustees, distinguished guests, family and friends, and most importantly, the class of 2023 to Eastern Maine Community College's 56th annual commencement ceremony. My name is Liz Russell. I am president of Eastern Maine Community College, and this celebration promises to be a memorable one for our graduates as we honor their achievements and promises for their future. Graduates, we are gathered here this morning to celebrate your determination, your commitment, your persistence, your success. We are gathered here because you said yes to a career or to continuing your education, yes to a better future for your family, yes to a stronger community, and yes for a better you. Here at EMCC, you have committed yourselves to seeking more knowledge, refining your crafts or trades, expanding your horizons academically as well as personally. Because of all of that, you are extraordinarily well positioned to not just take your next step, but jump feet first into your fields and make a very real impact. Your journey begins this morning. I look forward to this celebration of your future. Would you please rise for the singing of our national anthem by Grace Freeman, a 2021 EMCC Human Services graduate.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming. Red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the
You may be seated.
Good morning. My name is Jane Loxterkamp, the Interim Vice President of Academic Affairs, and I have the pleasure of introducing our platform party. At your far left is Mary Ellen Peterson, faculty in our nursing department. Charlie Vayu, faculty retired from refrigeration, air conditioning, and heating. Kate Rush, trustee of the Maine Community College System. Liz Russell, president of Eastern Maine Community College. Dave Daigler, president of the Maine Community College System. Katarina Bagri, the 2023 commencement speaker. Elizabeth True, vice president of student affairs. And Achilles Lopez, the 2023 student of the year. It is also my privilege to introduce those who have spent countless hours sharing their subject matter knowledge and passion for learning, those that have nurtured, counseled, advised, inspired, and encouraged our students, those that have pushed you, our graduates, day in and day out to give your very best, and those that push me to do the same. And those are our faculty. At this time, I ask the Maine Community College President Dave Daigler, Trustee Kate Rush, and Nursing Instructor Mary Ellen Peterson to come forward and bring you formal greetings to this 56th annual commencement of Eastern Maine Community College.
Thank you. Graduates, how about it? Yes, all right, let's hear it. So my job here is to bring all of you congratulations from all of the community colleges across the state. But if you bear with me for just a moment, I do have some thoughts that I'll share, but first indulge me because I want to thank the faculty, the staff who are intermingled throughout the audience, the family and friends who have come and are hanging in the rafters here to support you. You know, there's an African proverb that says that if you want to go fast, go alone. But if you want to go far, go together. Working together, you have taken these graduates farther than really even they realize. You've taught them, you've encouraged them, and you've supported them. And I've had the privilege of getting to know some of them personally. This is an awesome class of graduates. Without you, this celebration would not be nearly as special. And I want to thank you sincerely for all that you have done. Okay, graduates, it's your turn. You've studied hard. You've overcome immense challenges. You deserve to be proud of this accomplishment. But do remember, you've not done this alone. Remember those who helped you get here, and when you have a chance, help someone else achieve their dream. Now, I do have a thought that I'd like you to consider. As you begin your journey, and as President Russell indicated, this is a beginning, but as you begin your journey as alums of Eastern Maine Community College, there's a gentleman by the name of Alvin Toffler, who was an American business writer and businessman. He was also regarded as one of the world's great futurists. I don't know exactly what a futurist does, but I thought, I ought to sit back and pay attention. And then I read something he wrote. He said, "The illiterate of the 21st century will not be those who cannot read or write, but those who cannot learn, unlearn, and relearn." And I thought, this guy's on to something. Now, you're heading into a world with a degree and the skills you need to succeed. So you are prepared to conquer the challenges of today's workplace. But commencement is a beginning, not an end. And you can see that the world of work is changing very fast. As you move into that world, you'll want to get ahead, right? You're going to want to get a raise. To do that, you're going to need to learn more. You're going to want to advance in your field. You're going to have to adapt to new technologies. So plan to return here. Consider this college your lifelong partner in education. working together with your faculty and all your friends and all the staff that are here to support you, you have prepared yourself for this complex world. But by staying together, you can go farther than even you realize. You'll go farther than you ever dreamed you could. So, my final thought, today is a day of celebration. Please do celebrate. Celebrate responsibly, but celebrate. You deserve to be very, very proud of your accomplishment. Now, congratulations, thank you, and please welcome Trustee Rush to the podium.
Well, good morning. My name is Kate Rush, and on behalf of my colleagues at the Maine Community College System Board of Trustees, it is my great pleasure to be here with you today and to extend our congratulations to the graduating class of 2023. It takes courage, determination, and perseverance to be where you are today. These very same qualities will fuel your professional growth, strengthen our communities, and power the Maine economy. I can't wait to see where you go. On behalf of the trustees, I wish you each the very best. Your future is bright, and Maine's future is brighter with you in it. Congratulations.
Good morning. Welcome to all of you on this beautiful day. How could we have not wished for this lovely day? Graduates, you have done it. Congratulations, class of 2023. My name is Mary Ellen Peterson. I am a nurse and educator and retiring this week from the nursing program at Eastern Maine Community College. That doesn't mean I won't be back, I promise. I have been a nurse for 46 years. I have cared for and supported sick patients and their families, those with traumatic injuries, and those who have gone home to live normal lives. I have also been a teacher for 46 years. I have taught patients, young and old, along with their families, what they need to know about their care, the medicines they take, and the details of their diagnoses. I have also been a member of the nursing faculty here at the college for the last 10 years and have helped educate approximately 400 nurses for the community in which we live. Being an educator of a family, of families, patients, and students is the hardest job you will ever love. In the words of Parker J. Palmer, educator, it takes courage to teach. So, faculty, I commend you all on your perseverance and for having the courage to teach. My role as a nurse and as a teacher has been a journey I would never trade away for another. It is the best of two worlds that dovetail together to provide service for my community. Graduates, for my final lecture here at Eastern Maine Community College, I would like you all to break into groups right now. Go ahead. No, never mind. I'm kidding. Many of you have heard these very words from me and other faculty because working in teams can make a solution possible. As graduates of Eastern Maine Community College, You are the fire science experts, the criminal justice professionals, soon to be registered nurses, HVAC technicians, plumbers, electricians, medical assistants, radiographers, experts in the woodworking field, welders of safe bridges, and builders of our neighborhoods. You all are the fabric of our community. You, each of you, in your chosen field, will be instrumental in teaching your craft to those you serve. A couple of examples include, one, police will provide protection and education to keep us safe. Two, firefighters will teach school children how to stop, drop, and roll. Three, carpenters and electricians will explain the difference in price is between electric and hydroelectric heating in the flooring of my new home. I haven't a clue. For my last lecture, the objectives of this graduating class are as follows. Number one, communicate effectively, conveying ideas using speech and the written word. Participate as effective team members with individuals from diverse backgrounds to achieve a collaborative goal. Participate as independent learners. Assess, evaluate, and synthesize information that is relevant. Participate as problem solvers, resourcing evidence-based practice to make solutions. Your professional life awaits you. Your first day on the job, as a novice, you will be provided with an orientation. 10 weeks on the job, as an advanced beginner, you will be a provider in your chosen field. 25 weeks on the job, you will be competent at the job and be orienting new members of your team. 3 years on the job, you will be proficient and may go on to finish your bachelor's degree. You will be a significant asset to your organization. 5 years after graduation, you will be an expert in your chosen field. You may return to Eastern Maine Community College as a mentor, preceptor, teacher, be a member of an advisory committee, or benefactor of the college. At this point, you have become a lifelong learner. You are the newest, the best, and the most up-to-date member of the team. Now it is time to put it all together and graduate. In closing, your final exam will be to go forth and demonstrate the objectives of the program. Be the best at what you do and remember to give back as a teacher in the field you have chosen. A special thanks to President Russell for your support, Jane Loxer-Camp for Interim Vice President of Academics for your guidance, my peers in the nursing program, thank you all. Other faculty, family, guests, and for making this final lecture and graduation memorable. But most importantly, congratulations to you, the new bright professional class members of class of 2023. Where is she? Liz Crew.
Good morning, I'm Liz True, and I'm the Vice President for Student Affairs. Each year, each of the 7 community colleges within the Maine Community College system selects a student of the year for their academic success and campus and community involvement. In April, recipients of the Student of the Year received the John and Jana LaPointe Leadership Award at a ceremony held in Augusta. It is now my pleasure to introduce EMCC's Student of the Year, Achilles Lopez, a member of the Nursing Program Class of 2023.
Good morning. Dear class of 2023, being chosen as a student of the year and invited to speak to you with you all today is a humbling and unexpected honor. It has made me reflect on the twists and turns that have led me to this moment, and I want to briefly share with you what I think about my time here and how Eastern Maine Community College helped me become a stronger version of myself. I commute from Millinocket. It takes an hour and a half to get to school, depending on road conditions. And I remember continuing to school for an hour every day, getting up at 4 a.m. and driving along an unplowed Interstate 95 south to Bangor, gripping the steering wheel with sweat pouring down my palms as my mind would tell me, what was I thinking? When I walked into a patient's room with six IV lines, a chest tube, a ventilator, and 3 to 5 screens updating with real-time health information, I was thinking, what was I thinking? I remember being with another patient experiencing crushing chest pain and me frantically trying to find nitroglycerin and remember what protocol I have to do. And I asked and called for his nurse, and all that was going through my mind was, what was I thinking? While performing chest compressions for a patient in cardiac arrest and hearing the crack of his ribs, feeling the sudden sink in his chest, in my mind I was thinking, what in the world was I thinking? I can't pinpoint the moment when my fear changed into focus or when I let go of the past and embraced my future in this profession. What I can tell you is what happened afterward. Whenever I returned to class, I heard my classmates' struggles, my classmates' worries, and words of encouragement. I remembered that I had no room to complain. These strong, dedicated, and caring women with children, full-time work, and traditional students fresh from high school with more discipline than I had at their age. We're all here, we're all struggling with the same thoughts, the same anxieties, the same feelings of inadequacy in the face of an enormous responsibility that is caring for a human life. Their tenacity and resilience fueled me to keep pushing forward. I had to earn my place among them and attend every day, complete every assignment, and take every opportunity I could to grow. I had to make a choice along with every other student in this school that my dreams were more important than my comfort. I had to believe that those nights when we said no to those we love would eventually pay off, that every sacrifice would move us closer to this very moment. My perspective didn't change from an epiphany or a single experience. The slow, painful accumulation of lessons and situations allowed a stronger mindset to emerge from fear and doubt. This new mindset is not frantic in a crisis, but careful. Not anxious about what can go wrong, but focused on preventing the worst. And a mindset that is not afraid to care for others, but is ready to care for others. Every day, we all made small strides as we stepped closer to our new roles. Unconsciously, we have arrived at this moment, clad in graduation robes, surrounded by family and friends, celebrating our achievement and prepared for what lies ahead. As I look among us, the class of 2023, I see resilient, hardworking, dedicated people, people who kept coming back, people who put in the work, people who will continue to shape their lives rather than be shaped by them. As you sit with your family and friends celebrating this day, remember what happens when you challenge yourself and push yourself beyond your fear and decide that your dreams are more important than your comfort. Class of 2023, thank you for listening and congratulations.
Our commencement address this morning will be given by a 2021 graduate of EMCC's nursing program, Katarina Bagri. In May 2014, the war started in the eastern part of Ukraine, where she lived and worked. To save her life and the lives of her children, she left her home and job, seeking asylum in the United States. Today, Katarina works as a nurse at Maine Coast Memorial Hospital and teaches at EMCC, Beale University, and the University of Maine. It is my pleasure to introduce Katarina Bagri.
Which one is mine?
Hello, friends. Hello, colleagues. Hello, everyone who shares the passion of education and self-development. Thank you all for coming today and letting me speak with you. I appreciate that. I will develop my speech in two different ways. It will consist of two parts. First of all, I would like to congratulate all of you with such a great achievement, graduation with your associate's degree from Eastern Maine Community College. Congratulations, new grads. With all my heart, I understand what you went through, which obstacles you overcame. I understand how much time you dedicated to your study and how many sacrifices you made to become who you are right now. I relate to you in so many ways. I'm a non-traditional student, as I started my career when I was older than 30 years old. I have a doctorate degree from a foreign country, and when I came here, I was not able to transfer it, unfortunately. So I started my education and career from the very beginning. This makes me a non-traditional student, a first-generation student, and a second-career student at the same time. I'm an immigrant from the Ukraine, as Liz Russell mentioned. And obviously, I'm an English second language person, fourth language, actually. So it took many more hours for me to understand, translate, write, read than many other students dedicated to their studies. I have seen in my life human-made disaster, the war that started on the day when I was walking on the street and had a clear sky over my head. I saw the first bombs. I have four children who now live with me. Two of them came with me from that war area, and I have no other family members here. All my family is back in the Ukraine, and they refuse to move out because they are dedicated to their community and their doctors who take care of the injured and wounded patients there. I worry about them every day. I lost my grandfather due to the war when I was in the first semester of my nursing program at Eastern Maine Community College. That person dedicated more than two decades to my life, my education, and my development. Also, right after my first semester at EMCC, I experienced homelessness, and I suffered the divorce, the betrayal, and I lost two children who I considered to be mine for 5 years. So my journey was quite adventurous, definitely. I had an experience of having no money, and I mean no money, to pay for my college, for my education, for my books, for my transportation, and sometimes for food. And I appreciate everything that EMCC done for me with the emotional, financial, and just overall support, everything. Thank you very much. Do you relate to anything that I mentioned in the list of my adventures? I'm sure that some of you do. I see that in your eyes. And I'm really, really proud that you overcame those obstacles, that you had the power to overcome whatever was in your way to success and graduate today. There is nothing more pleasurable to me to see that you shine in the light of newly developed self-confidence, feeling of being empowered and willingness to go forward with your graduation and never give up your dream. I understand, value, and praise your dedication. I am sure you will succeed in proceeding forward. Welcome to the kingdom to those who overcome the obstacles. Congratulations, new grads. Secondly, we all know that tomorrow is Mother's Day. So I would like to congratulate my mom with the Mother's Day. Happy Mother's Day, Mom. I have not seen you for 7 years. I have not touched or kissed or hugged you or argued with you for 7 years. Guys, love your moms. Say thank you to your moms. Kiss them. Hug them. Talk to them. Call them. Send texts to them. I only have a couple minutes on Skype, maybe every other week or so. And I am so grateful that I do have this time. Enjoy every second that you have them around. Happy Mother's Day, Mom. Happy Mother's Day to every mom in the world. And again, new grads, congratulations.
Stay right there. Katarina, in appreciation for joining us for our commencement exercises, it is my pleasure to present this gift, which was made by our fine woodworking and cabinet making program. We hope that you will think of us now and then as you enjoy this handmade cutting board.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Charlie Vayu is a longtime dedicated employee of Eastern Maine Community College who retired, yet continues to serve the college and our students as a lab assistant for the refrigeration, air conditioning, and heating program. He is a strong supporter of the mission of the college, as witnessed by his support for both technical and general education as vital components for the success of students. Charlie was hired at EMCC in 1990 and retired from the college in May 2021. For over 30 years, Charlie served as an instructor and department chair of the refrigeration, air conditioning, and heating program. He has extensive expertise in the field and brought clear direction and strong leadership to the program during his tenure. Of particular note, he developed several courses that meet the state of Maine licensing and certification requirements. During his employment, he kept abreast of the current trends and practices in the field and shared his knowledge and expertise with not only his associate degree students, but with members of the industry who needed to be certified in HVAC areas. Charlie was an outstanding faculty member who believes in giving back to those who followed him. He currently serves as a mentor for the new faculty member in our department chair. He has shared his expertise in curriculum design, pedagogy, laboratory assignments with these faculty members. This is his legacy, and the refrigeration, air conditioning, and heating program is stronger because of his willingness to share his knowledge and expertise with others. On behalf of Eastern Maine Community College and the Maine Community College system, it is my honor to award Charlie Vayu the Faculty Emeritus status. At this point, I'd like to take a moment to acknowledge those students who have distinguished themselves academically by achieving a grade point average of 3.75 or higher. These students have earned the status of high honors. These students noted in your program and their achievement will be recognized on their transcripts and diplomas. I would like these students to stand now and be recognized. Please join me in applauding them. Thank you so much for your dedication to your studies. So now I'd like to recognize another group of students. These are the students who have a grade point average between 3.25 and 3.75. These students have earned the status of honors. These students are noted in your program, and their achievements will also be recognized on their transcripts and diplomas. I would like those students to stand now and be recognized. Congratulations. It is very noteworthy that you've made this achievement. Graduation from a program means that a student is prepared to enter his field and succeed. So faculty take pride in all of their graduates. Students who distinguish themselves within their discipline are recognized through our Excellence in Technology Award. Faculty in the technical departments choose the Excellence in Technology Award recipients on the basis of technical skills, leadership, and work ethic. In making their decision, faculty look at how students have interacted with their peers, instructors, and the rest of the college. They also consider the grade point average, and most importantly, they consider the student's mastery of the discipline. The students who receive this award exemplify the best accomplishments of each technical program. As I call your name, will the students receiving the Excellence in Technology Award please rise and remain standing? I will ask that you hold your applause until the end when we can recognize them together. Excellence in Awards in Excellence in Technology. Automotive Technology, Christopher Bergeron. Building Construction, Sarah Stewart. Business Management Career Option, Heather Bridges. Business Management Career Transfer Option, Dania Parsons. Computer Technology, Mitchell Fluellen. Criminal Justice, Sydney Levitt. Culinary Arts, Makey Lee. Diesel, Truck, and Heavy Equipment, Victoria Burbe. Digital Graphic Design, Aaron Blake. Electrical Programs, Michael Petrovich. Fine Woodworking, Bailey Means. Human Services, Mary Jane Bureau. Liberal Studies, Arthur Smallage. Medical Assistant Technology, Chad Reed. Medical Office Technology, Nicole Davis. Medical Radiography, Kylie Woodman. Nursing, Emily Luce. Plumbing, Peyton Voss. Refrigeration, Air Conditioning and Heating, Cole Desargins. Restaurant Management, Sarah Deal. And Welding Technology, Jason Russell. Thank you so much for all of your hard work, and I look forward to you entering your professions. Now we've come to the part of the ceremony that you've all excited about. With the recommendation of the faculty, and by the authority of the Board of Trustees of the Maine Community College System in the state of Maine, I am honored to present the class of 2023 to President of Eastern Maine Community College, Liz Russell, who will confer the academic awards, which do include degrees, certificates, and advanced certificates. Candidates, please remain seated until the usher instructs you to come to the stage. President Russell, as Vice President of Academic Affairs, it is my privilege to present the Eastern Maine Community College graduating class of 2023.
Associate in Applied Science, Automotive Technology. Chris M. Bergeron. Christopher Austin Daigle. Jesse James Frazier. Richard Johnson. Anson Ray Kelly. Daniel Robert Lofton. Certificate, Automotive in Basic Systems. Cole J. La Rochelle. Dylan S. LaPlante. Associate in Applied Science, Building Construction Technology. Logan Carter. Cooper A. Corey. Ethan Andrew Rack. Andrew Secord. Maxwell Charles Stevens. Sarah Ann Stewart. Associate in Applied Science, Business Management Career Option. Brandon Harris Walterkins. Liam Spaulding. Sydney C. Sutter. Associate in Applied Science, Business Management Transfer Option, Chase Richard Brassbridge. Hunter David Link. Danyon A. Parsons. Acadia Aaron Reese. Erica Simons. Connor Patrick Yakalovich. Certificate, Business Management, Small Business Development, Aubrey Boyce. Parker Keith Edwards. Danielle K. Fenlison. Ethan Troy Whitty. Associate in Arts, Career Studies, Ryan Christopher Adams. Julia Valentina Butler. James Michael Willis Dumont. Cole Robert Francis. Kristen Dory Garish. Gary Michael Glidden. Jalen Chanel Hills. Maggie Bernadette Lincoln. Safira Rose Drescher Murphy. Kimberly L. Penny. Alexis O. M. Wilson. Associate in Applied Science, Computer Technology, Coding, Mitchell Lloyd Fluelling. Paige A. Scheel. Associate in Applied Science and Computer Technology Networking, Nicholas Patrick Avery Lander. Philippe Nesrama. Samuel S. Thomas. Associate in Applied Science, Criminal Justice, Alexis M. Austin. Ian Fasella. Sydney A. Levitt. Devin McFarlane. Robert G. Tippett V. Associate in Applied Science, Culinary Arts, Sarah R. Deal. Zachary Darrell Garnett. Mai Chi Lee. Associate in Applied Science, Restaurant and Food Service Management, Jennifer Irene Allen. Brenda Jean Bernier. Associate in Applied Science, Diesel, Truck, and Heavy Equipment, Christopher Beatty. Baruby. Victoria A. Berube. Jacob W. Flowers. Kendra A. Merrill. Riley Thomas Micklick. Cameron J. Monroe. Nathaniel J. Robinson. Associate in Applied Science, Digital Graphic Design, Aaron Blake. Caroline Decker. Kylie Angel Johnson. Natalie Jean Caressman. Haley Metzger. Riley Norman White. Associate in Applied Science, Education, Early Childhood, Teresa Renee Berry. Elizabeth Clark. Associate in Applied Science, Education, Elementary K through 8 option, Haley Savannah Anderson. Jenna Lynn Anderson. Miranda Ann Batchelder. Paris Madison Bork. Jacob Clark. Hannah B. Crabtree. Megan Tracy Letty. Associate in Applied Science, Education, Secondary 7 through 12 option, Ryan Matthew Drinkwater. Stephanie Renee Gorrell. Diana Harriman. Certificate, Education for Career and Technical Educators, Jason E. Tyler. Associate in Applied Science, Electrical and Automation, Benton William Foglio. Timothy Vaughn Jewell. Woojin Lee. Hyewon Min. Michael Anthony Petrikovich V. Jared James Willett. Certificate, Electricians Technology, Colby Steve Charette. Jacob A. Cook. Drew R. Colombe. Alexandra Duplessis. Finney F. Foley. Lucas H. Greenlaw. Owen Thomas Griffin. Sean Scott Marble. Tyler Ryan McCannell. Luke R. M. Potter. Matthew M. Reed. Marcus James Varner. Associate in Applied Science, Fine Woodworking and Cabinet Making, Samuel L. Cannon. Molly Catherine Cassidy. Norman Delton Corliss Jr. Jasmine Noelle Dixon. James Lipinski. Bailey Hill Means. Associate in Applied Science, Fire Science, Benjamin M. Karen. Jacob S. January. Associate in Applied Science, Human Services, Crystal Octavia Babcock. Teresa Fallon. Savannah S. Ford. Branson Scott Goodine. Scott A. Knowles. Amy Quarian. Joshua J. Warren. Certificate, Human Services, Substance Abuse Rehabilitation, Teresa L. Dumond. Associate in Arts, Liberal Studies, Emily Teresa Stroba. Amy Glover Goodson. Patch Green. Melissa Ann Honenberger. Joshua M. January. Skylar E. Mannion. Kaylee Ann Meehan. Nicholas Pino. Trinity Plord. Hajra Soda. Jesse E. Sherwood. Arthur McCray Smallage. Hannah Naomi Stimson. Logan Noel Thomas. Francine Starr Wilson Cherick. Associate in Applied Science, Medical Assisting, Amber Lynn Bosley. Rebecca Ann Chappell. Sophia Inman. Michaela Ray Talbot. Certificate, Medical Assisting, Kira Lynn Cannon. Josie May Gray. Travis Lee Harnish. Hillary Lynn LeBate. Jennifer S. Lenfest. Missouri. Heather S. Meserve. Emily M. Pelkey. Amber Marie Reed. Katie Ray Smith. Kayla Spain. Shay Grace Story. Diana Marie Young. Associate in Applied Science, Medical Office Technology, Coding Option, Melissa Mary Grant. Associate in Applied Science, Medical Office Technology, Amaya M. Hollowell. Ashton Novak. Associate in Science Medical Radiography, Calla Ann Balboni. Katie Ann Clements. Jerry Lee Cox, Jr. Alyssa Day. Austin M. Deshane. Jason M. Dumas. Callie May Joseph. Brittany Scott Modry. Michaela J. Moulton. Mackenzie Nutt. Kaylee L. Tebow. Kylie Woodman. Associate in Science Nursing, Nia Abbott. Emma Catherine Ashmore. Rachel E. Barnes. Emma Renee Butler. Helen Elizabeth Call. Stacy Carpenter. Amy Lynn Cluley. Anna Golick Conway. Mariah Jane Cormier. Gabrielle A. Currier. Sarah Marie Gadu. Elizabeth Leanne Gagne. Daniel Michelle Giroux. Margaret M. Gilgan. Brianne Marie Hackett. Jade Alexis Harmon. Holly M. Hutchinson. Ashley Ann Jackson. Christy Lynn Jackson. Hannah May Landry. Tram Andole. First generation graduate, Melissa Sue LePage. Emily Luce. Bailey Peterson. Sabrina Sharrow. Georgina Thomas. Emily Thompson. Ariane K. Isla Tolentino. Justice Joanne Vachon. Carrie Lynn Walker. Achilles Antonio Lopez. Certificate, Plumbing, Harrison W. Bowen. Kai Stewart Brown. Neil Cole. Donald Eldridge IV. Emily Grassi. Nathaniel D. Hutchins. Riley Joseph Latin. Henry O. Sabatine. Noah Michael Trueworthy. Associate in Applied Science, Refrigeration, Air Conditioning, and Heating, Cole Henry Desjardins. Dominic O. Brown. Lucas Duff. Morgan Faulkner. Nathan K. Ilunga. Michael Joyce. Luke William Kelly. Samuel Carver Sinibaldi. Associate in Applied Science, Surgical Technology, Nicole S. Arlen. Chelsea Elizabeth Bork. Chelsea E. Canavan. Paige Carter. Angela Chamberlain. Madison Ann Marie Corliss. Michaela Hamilton. Kisten Lee Kilton. Anissa M. Levasser. Michaela Pratt. Lindsay Jean Smart. Certificate, Pipe Welding Technology, Tristan A. Day. Associate in Applied Science, Welding Technology, Caleb A. Bennett. Taylor Tatro. Molly Nagel. John Michael Dion. Caleb W. Prather. Chase Keezer. Ethan William Michaud. Thomas Colin Watson. Dakota Yackel.
Well done, graduates. Eastern Maine Community College has helped thousands of individuals like yourselves to thrive in fields such as healthcare, technology, construction, transportation, business, education, and public safety. This college has been here for anyone who seeks to use the power of education to make something for themselves, their families, and for their communities. Today, over 350 of you will join those ranks and continue the remarkable reputation EMCC graduates have in this community and beyond.
And always, no matter where you are, remember, you have a family here at Eastern Maine Community College who care about you. I have no doubt that each of you will find your way. You will live your dream. You will become who you were meant to be and end up where you are needed most. And the world will never be the same because of you. On behalf of the entire campus, I thank each of you for your perseverance. Your success means everything to us, and we are so proud of what you have accomplished. Graduates of the class of 23, would you please rise? You may now move your tassel from the right to the left to signify your commencement. Faculty, staff, family, and friends, I present to you the Eastern Maine Community College Class of 2023. I wish you all the best in the world as you endeavor on your next journey. Now go and live the biggest life you can. Would the audience please remain in the auditorium until the graduates have exited? Graduates, please wait to be released by your row. And we're going up.